Bang outside, hang outside. Don't come out the house, cause the gang outside. Bang outside, I hang outside. Don't come out the house, cause the gang outside. Bang outside, hang outside.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then hey girl, go ahead, make yourself comfortable cause you're family now. On this channel, we talk about all things beauty, that's hair, makeup, and every now and then I might throw in a vlog or two. Today's video is gonna be inspired by the makeup artist that's like a very popular makeup artist on Instagram. His name is Kevin Luong. I hope I'm saying his name right. His Instagram channel is right here. I'm sure you heard about him, child, everybody has. He is widely known for his very beautiful yet subtle soft glam look. So that's what this video is going to be today. It's going to be like a little bit of an incorporation of my style with his, and that's how we got this look that we have going on today. So if you're interested in seeing how I got this look, then stay tuned and watch the whole video. I'm going to start with prepping my skin. I'm going to use Milk Hydro, and I like to apply this pretty much everywhere around my face except for this inner part in my T-zone, because I personally like to mix primers because I just feel like everybody is not just one skin type. Some of us are, but I'm gonna use both of these. I'm gonna use MAC mattifying primer as well as my Milk Hydro primer. I'm just gonna make it as close as possible to what I see his models with, basically. Okay, so we have our bronzer. Yeah, I'm not gonna do it the exact way he do it because I don't know, but yeah, we're gonna get it as close as possible. We're using bronzer. I'm using my Fashion Fair in Suede Silk. And then we are going to use my favorite concealers. I personally love the Born This Way concealer. From what I noticed with his makeup on his page, it's very like soft glam. It's nothing crazy, you know, none like outrageous. So I'm pretty much gonna do like my own steps, you know. Like I said, we're just gonna make it as close to what he has. I'm gonna color correct a little bit this little dark spot on my forehead because it's really dark and I don't want to have to fight with it. Typically, you know, I don't have to color correct, but in this case, which I should have did that first, to be honest, before I put that concealer on. I'm using MAC's color corrector palette. I only color correct whenever I have like a really, really dark spot on my face. Like I could color correct these two, those here. I had a bump on my forehead from the scarf being too tight. I also get hyperpigmentation, which is normal amongst African-American women or anyone who has melanin in their skin. Some people are lucky enough not to go through that problem, but then you got people like me who have to go through that problem. In order for you to not see it from within the makeup, you have to color correct. That way it don't look crazy. See, you can't even see it no more. I'm using these two concealers because I like it to be a little bit brighter underneath the eyes, like a contrast basically. His models, they have bright under eyes as well, so I'm gonna take it that he liked to do this too. It's really turning into Keisha way, but we're gonna get it there. I'm also gonna use my concealer as my base because he has this signature look of just like nice, beautiful, flawless, soft makeup. All his girls look like that. I mean, some of the girls may have like different things like rhinestones, like if it's a look that they're doing. But for the most part, they all have like this very soft glam. Sometimes it'll be bronzy, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do like a bronzy type of look. So I don't need a primer for my eyelids. I can use my concealer, and I like to let it sit a little bit only because I feel like you get the most coverage whenever you let it sit just a little bit, especially with this concealer, which is amazing by the way. I'm gonna use NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. I'm just gonna shake this up very well. I'm just gonna pump a couple of pumps on the back of my hand, and then I'm gonna apply it with this brush instead of a sponge because you get a little bit more coverage, but I'm gonna blend it out with the sponge though. we have a beauty blender. I'm gonna use the beauty blender with some setting spray, some Fix Plus, just to get it damp. I'm gonna be using the product on the back of my hand too, just in case if what I just put on wasn't enough. So we have the foundation blended all out. Since we already have like concealer and bronzer like already going on, I don't see a point in doing a full face of foundation. But if you want to, then go ahead, sis. Now I'm just gonna blend out the concealer. I like to use a brush instead of the beauty blender. We're just gonna blend this out and bring the concealer up a little bit so that it marries in with the bronzer. And I'm doing stipple motions instead of like swiping. Can you see how that's? Yes. I'm also taking some of that product from the brush that's left over and just doing my chin a little bit and around on the sides of the mouth. And then we're gonna work our way up to this middle part, the forehead. You see what I mean though? You can't see that dark spot anymore. Okay, so we have all of that blended out. Now I'm gonna do a Morphe E6 brush. Oh, the first brush that I used was the Morphe G34. So these both are Morphe brushes, which I like Morphe brushes. Everybody got their own opinion about them, but I feel like for the price point, they're very good quality. And I've had my brushes, honestly, now probably for like 7 years now, since like 2015, I've had these brushes. I'm kind of bringing that bronzer that we put on, that cream bronzer, down instead of like keeping it in one space, because I want to make my forehead smaller because I got a big forehead, in my opinion. But now I'm just going to go back to this Morphe G34 brush and we're just going to blend out the eye. And while I'm doing the eye, I'm still doing tap, 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 tap motions instead of the swiping. Unless I'm at the corners, like at the ends like that, I'm just trying to blend that out. So I swipe that part, but that's it. I love the way the skin look already. And I like to dip my damp beauty blender in and we're just gonna set this area. Anywhere you get the most oiliest is where you wanna place the powder. So I'm applying it mostly on just my T-zone. Also, if you want to try to avoid smile lines, which is very common, apply the powder in the corners of the creases of the mouth. You also want to set the eyelids too, since we did put concealer on top. And I'm just gonna blend that area out to avoid any creases or any lines. That way it looks flawless all around. And then we're gonna take that same setting powder, the same damp beauty blender, and just apply it onto the lids. So we've set our eyes, underneath the eyes, pretty much where the concealer was. Now we need to set our bronzer. I'm so conflicted. I'm like, I don't know if I want to use my Fashion Fair or if I want to use my Fenty, because I haven't been using my Fenty lately, ever since this product came into my life, because it's so amazing. It's so amazing. So amazing. Hands down. Best powder. Both of these are like neck to neck, but this is really like, this is okay. And the fact that it's black owned, baby, we might as well make this like a black owned video. Well, Too Faced isn't black owned, so no, we can't do that. So which one do y'all like the most? If you ever tried it, do you like the Fenty more or do you like the Fashion Fair? If you tried it yet. See, Coco Natty is just like that perfect weight. Actually, we're gonna try something else. So another product that I recently just purchased from Sephora. Actually, I have a few products that I just recently went and bought in Sephora, and I've been trying this product out as well. And that's the Charlotte Tilbury powder. It's the Charlotte Tilbury bronzer. I got it in a mini first because I wasn't sure if I wanted to invest in a full size product yet from this brand, only because I'm gonna be honest with y'all. Like, I mean, I see the girls using Charlotte Tilbury, but I always felt like Charlotte Tilbury wasn't for me, you know, for my skin tone. So I was like, I don't know, but I've been using this and it's actually pretty good. We gonna use this instead of fighting about Fenty or Fashion Fair. We're gonna use the Charlotte Tilbury today. I'm gonna take MAC's 150S brush and we're just gonna take a little bit of this product in here like that. We're gonna start on this side. And I always like to start from the back and then come up to the front because wherever you place the brush is where most of the product is gonna go. See, because you can see it, boom, right there, right? I'm just gonna use this color. I like this color because it's very neutral. It's not super red and it's not like fake looking. It's actually really pretty. Like when I showed y'all up close, when you look at this powder, you will be like, this look like your skin tone. But no, this isn't deep too, number 4 deep. And look how it looks on me. I also kind of like to kind of bring it up on the cheeks a little bit, like smile and let it hit the cheeks. That way, see, look how good that looks. Yeah. Once this is done, I'm gonna end up buying the big bottle, or the full size version of the Charlotte Tilbury bronzer, because this is, the girls need this one. See, look how good that look. And it's so hard to like find a good bronzer from my skin tone because I'm not super red, but a lot of bronzers make me red or make me orange. But this is very neutral, so it's just like so perfect. It keeps me looking like I'm more yellow than red, but my bronzer be making me look very red. It looks like me when I'm tan, but this is like a perfect. I'm gonna do a video on this. I ain't gonna be bragging too much on this product right now. If you're interested in seeing the products that I purchased from Sephora and my opinions about it, then let me know in the comments below, child. We also gonna bring this powder down the neck just to sculpt it and to not have like that double neck like I got. I'm looking at his picture, like this girl, she's pretty. Like her makeup is really pretty. I'm actually just gonna recreate this exact look, to be honest, because it's really pretty and I'm here for it. Yeah, we just gonna use her as our model. Either her or her, because her makeup is pretty too as well. They're both very similar. Back to it, I just had to look at my reference again, going out doing my own little thing. Another thing I noticed is he really sculpts this area. You know, I personally don't care to do all of that. Since this is a Kevin Luong and Keisha recreation, we gonna just, you know, do what he did. I'm just taking some setting powder and I'm using my air sponge this time. We're gonna take our sponge and I'm just going to sculpt the face because that's what he does. And then we're gonna do this up. It should be like that. And we just gonna let this sit while I do the eyes. I used to do this to my makeup, but I'm not really into doing that no more. I always kind of like to just brush my eyebrows up a little bit to get some of that product off because we've been using a lot of powders and it's all over my brows right now. So now we're just gonna go into the eyes. And at this point, I'm gonna use the new Persuasion palette. And this is by Melissa, Beauty by Melissa. I saw it on Instagram. I fell in love with it because just look at the color. It's like so perfect. I love this mirror first off, but just get in tune into these colors, sis. Look at the color choices. I'm like here for this palette. Yeah, it's a really beautiful palette with an array of colors in this black owned business. So let's support our sis. We're first gonna take Chocola, this color right here, and we're gonna put her right in the crease. Oh, that's pretty already. I like that. I'm also just flinging this color out a little bit just so it doesn't look like it's just stuck in one spot. And we're just gonna blend that out. I like to first apply it by packing the color on and then blending it out. Then we blending up. I'm gonna kind of deepen this up a little bit, just a little bit, and I'm gonna use Mocha this time. But I just want to kind of see, yeah, we're gonna use Mocha. I just want to kind of deepen up the corner of my eye just a little bit to give it some dimension. Even though the girl in the picture, she don't look like she have more than like two colors on, but that's the point of blending. When you blend very well, it could look like it's one, but it's really probably two, you know. See, I just need that little bit of color, you know. know, deepness in there. Just set it off. Set it off. Set it off. Set it off. Is that what he said? Set it down? I don't know. Y'all know that song by Dream. Set it down? Shut it down? I don't know. The difference between this side and this side. Yeah, I needed that a little bit. Just a little bit of contrast. Just a little bit. And I'm kind of flinging it to marry with that first color that we used. So I'm flinging it out too. So it looks cohesive. So after we put that down, we're going to just take the first brush that we used to apply the first color and blend those together. I'm actually going to take Caramel, this color right here. I'm going to use the same brush and just kind of blend the outer parts to make everything blend together. Okay, I feel like we've been letting this sit a little. So what I'm going to do now is take MAC Mineral Skin Finish. And I'm just going to pounce that all into this area to blend it, to marry it together. That way I don't have that line of demarcation because I hate that personally. So I'm just going to sweep that all over here. I really feel like this part is not dark enough like this girl. So I'm gonna actually take now Cafe, which is like cool tone, dark color, dark brown color. But I'm just kind of creating like a V. Just gonna apply her, gonna build her up a little bit more, pouncing that color on and then flicking it out. Yeah, that's better. Even though I know he used a liner too, it's so soft that you can't really tell because of her lashes, but I could tell that it's literally just like right on the outer parts, like a outer V. In this picture, it's like a little sheen on the eyelid. It looks like it's almost nothing. I'm trying to use products that y'all could use too, but just grab something similar. It doesn't have to be the same exact thing. Grab something very similar to it. Focus more so on the technique, not the products. So I'm gonna take this palette from MAC that was Holiday. I'm gonna take this color that's right here at the top and I'm just gonna use my finger to apply it. And I'm literally just tapping it on my eyelid. None crazy. It low-key looked like he used a couple of, cause it's like a sheen on her eyelid here. And then it's like a lighter sheen on the inside, like a highlight. So I'm just packing the color onto my eyelid. I'm gonna go back in with the Chocola and just kind of blend the edges of where I just placed that, because the way he has it is so soft. So soft. When I say y'all need to blend till the wheels fall off. Blend, baby, blend. Yeah, that's what he did. He blend very good. So it also looks like he kind of took the liner on the bottom, but just the first inner part of the eye, and then he took that brown shade that like we used earlier and just kind of the Chocola and use it right on the bottom part. My eye shape is different from hers, so. And that's one thing you also need to be mindful about is your eye shape, because we all got different eye shapes. You just gotta know how and where to place shadows. So I already have almond eyes, big almond eyes. I'm just gonna connect the liner that we use, the pencil, with the liner, because it's soft but I could tell that there's a line with lashes. So I'm just gonna do like a very thin line, not a wing or anything. I'm gonna be using Merit's mascara. I'm gonna use Wood Winked because it's not super highlighted, but it's definitely a little bright right here, like on her. It's literally right in the center of her eyes, y'all can see. Now we're gonna apply some lashes. All Okay, this is how it's coming so far. Y'all tell me what y'all think about it. Now we're gonna go into with some blush. This is Raisin from MAC Cosmetics, and then this is Burnt Pepper. These colors that I'm choosing to apply on myself is what will give me that effect that he's using on her, like the same color he's using on her. I'm gonna just apply it like here. So I just mixed these two, but I'm just gonna first pounce it and blend it up and kind of across the apples of the cheeks. See the difference though? Blush, no blush. I'm gonna take this MAC Mineral Blush, and this is in Flirting with Danger. I just need something a little bit brighter. Like, yes, that's what I need, because they got this certain type of color to them to just give me like that, you know. Okay, so now we're gonna do the brows. I like the way he do their brows. They are very like natural looking, and it's not giving draw on or marker, which I hate those type of brows. So girl, we not doing those. I'm gonna use this MAC Big Boost, and I'm using the shade Spiked. I'm just using this to fill in and kind of push up the brows. To define it a little bit, I'm gonna take Stud, and this is in the shape and shade brow product. It's like a brow tint, so it has like a powder on the end, a powder applicator, and then it has like this fine point to it. But I'm just gonna take this to kind of define it a little bit more, doing light little strokes to make it look like it's growing from my face. Oh, see how I kind of just defined it a little bit. We're gonna take the same palette that I used earlier for that corrector, the lighter shade NC45, and kind of mix it with NC50. He doesn't do like a crazy defined brow. It's mostly like here where he will put the concealer that I noticed. It's just like under the brow, right up in there. Kind of drag it down a little bit. And now we're just gonna blend it out, and we're gonna blend it down like little strokes going down. I'm gonna do something with my hair really fast, and I'm going to change, and we'll be right back. So we're back, and now we're just gonna do the lips. I ain't forget about that, y'all. I'm gonna use Velvet Teddy as my lipstick, and I'm just gonna put this right in the center because she has like a very natural nude look where it looks like it's just lip gloss and lip liner. I'm just going based off of what I see. I'm just gonna line my lips with this lip pencil, which is Cork by MAC Cosmetics. Even though hers don't look as defined as I want it to, I'm just gonna kind of trace under with Chestnut because it's too blended for me right now. We're gonna put a little lip gloss on top. I'm gonna use Lust Lip Gloss by MAC Cosmetics, and I'm just gonna put it in the center. I use disposable ones for my lip gloss because I don't want to mess up the brush, so if you're wondering. Oh yes, 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 she's giving. Okay, and that's it. So this is the complete look of our tutorial for today. Let me know in the comments how you feel I did. Give me a ranking. I'm interested in knowing if I was even close to it. I tried to do the best I can, and also keep in mind that me and the model that I chose, our shapes are different, everything is different. So this is for me and my skin tone. If you like videos like this, then please hit the like button as well as subscribe if you haven't already, and join the family. I'll see y'all next time. Deuces.